ghost fields. Memories that will forever haunt me. The Night Owl's last stand. For centuries, the Night Owls had watched over the land. Here we fought the greatest threat Numbra had ever faced. The Black Swarm. My former pupil was only a baby when I found her. Another orphan of war. I took her under my wing and taught her everything I knew. Her name was Revoria.
Later.
Despite her feats, she wasn't much liked within the Order. She was perceived as an outsider. She was never one of us. On that day, the day of the last stand, she saved Numbra, but doomed us all at the same time. She leaked our meeting point to the enemy and left her post during the night. With most of the swarm coming our way, Revoria intended to infiltrate the Black Queen's lair to take her down and finally put an end to this bloodshed. We were caught completely off guard. I can still hear the loud buzzing coming from the east. Screech pierced the sky. A scream carried on the Black Queen's last breath. Revoria had sneaked up on her and delivered a fatal blow while her army was busy slaughtering us. Frenzied state had destroyed itself. And Revoria, well, she had paid the price with her life. Revoria, a traitor and an enemy. could Rivoria decide to throw away so many lives by revealing our location to the enemy? They asked. I had no answer. I was overwhelmed by grief and shame. I exiled myself to a life of solitude. Rumors were that the Order, or what was left of it, disbanded not long after that. I haven't heard from any member of the Order since that day. I am the Last Night Owl, a title that will mock me until my death. And so, here I am, old and feeble, stuck with you on this dangerous adventure. I knew our journey to Sylveon would be a perilous undertaking, as if the countless dangers of the Viperous Forest weren't trouble enough. We also had to face Rivoria's old traps hidden in the wild. It might have been my destiny all along to come back here and face her one last time.
Kittens, what are you doing?
No. Bill the cat. He needs to, or he just did? Bill the cat. Where'd you go? Come here, buddy. Sure, why not? Let's run it. Okay. Rolling.
Careful. Rivoria's creations are hidden everywhere around us.
Like right there. Just for a demonstration there. I think I did that. So there's a story element there, which I already got. Trap, run. Trap, run. There's hidden villager in that spot right there. Don't do that. Hidden villager there as well. That's trap. So basically, choose your entrances here carefully because some of them are traps.
Met you, I thought you were nothing more than a mindless fool. But somehow, you always managed to pull through.
And here is the other lore. Don't do it like that. We are totally going for this. Maybe not. Thank you.
Oh.
Just about had it. Timing. How does it work? This is gonna take a little doing. Made it. Cool. Now I just have to get back. Boom. This gets a little bit tricky here. Gets a bit tricky. Gotta time that last box just right. This way, we go up here. Okay, so this gets a little tricky. And I'm no speedrunner. Here. And that's how we do that.
That's dead end. Trick is to do that.
I can't believe this. Ravonia, they built a shrine in your honor. I can finally be at peace now that her legacy is saved.
And that's how that's done.
After so many years, I felt as if a huge weight had been taken off my shoulders, knowing that my owl brothers, in the end, had understood that Ravoria had made all those sacrifices to protect Numbra, put my mind at rest. The mistakes of my past would no longer plague me. Thankfully, the boy and I were unharmed by Ravoria's forgotten traps. The road to Sylveon was still long and treacherous, but at long last, we saw the light at the end of the tunnel.
By the low road.
Luxana might be in the capital, protecting the Kamloops as we speak.
Well, here's hoping. I'm not feeling real optimistic about that, but... It's interesting how there's kind of the... high path and short path. Maybe that was a Kamloops villager guy? Dozens of creatures hidden in the wild. Just wish they wouldn't pounce on us at any moment. Suddenly, out of nowhere, I was pulled from behind. Paddlewood, you idiot! Why did you follow us here? It's dangerous, Shen said angrily. You're the one who ran away. It's not very nice of you, Commander. A loud rubbing noise interrupted us. It seemed like something huge was dragging itself against the forest's grass and trees. My immediate thought was that the black swarm might be coming. But... are you lost, little lambs? A new meal for your king, perhaps? Delicious. A giant snake that couldn't be anyone else than Slash, the king of the forest, emerged from the shadows and slowly surrounded our party with his endless tail. I'd never seen a creature that size. It was twice the size of Animus. His skin was thick and battle-scarred, the mark of a deadly predator that had bested countless foes in its lifetime. I looked around only to realize that everyone was frozen in fear. Even Ashen couldn't hide his stupor. Curious beings. I've never seen your kind before. The king should know all of his subjects, Slash continued. The snake inched himself closer, his cold eyes gazing at me. I've tasted every creature that inhabits my domain. I wonder why you taste like. I had to think of a way to get us out of here. Suddenly, I remembered what Gripix had told me about Slash. He was as self-conceited as he was powerful. That's why he proclaimed himself king and named the forest in his honor. Your domain, you say? I didn't know it was yours. Who are you? I asked. The snake was stunned for a brief moment. Couldn't comprehend what he had just heard. Ah, pathetic mongrels. Dare you offend your king? He hissed. Asan looked at me incredulous. What are you doing? She whispered. Get us all killed. I had no time to explain. I had to keep going and bet on his vanity and buy us some time. Didn't mean to offend you, but I've never heard of a king in the Kamloops forest before, I continued. The snake was fuming. Not only did I pretend to not know who he was, but I had also misnamed his kingdom. You worms. So insulting. So disrespectful. Before I devour you lot, I will make sure to educate you on the grandeur of Slash, the king of Viperia's forest. My plan was succeeding. Slash then began a lengthy monologue about his countless prowess. As he rambled on and on, crew slowly realized what was going on. The snake became so distracted by his own story, reenacting glorious moments of his past, they started to forget about us completely. I looked around and discreetly gestured the crew to follow me. He silently escaped as he was busy talking about his preferred creatures to have for dinner. Then, we started to run. We arrived back at the Order's elevator, panting, as we suddenly heard a shrieking cry across the forest. Slesh had finally realized what had just happened.
Job to finish.
Yeah, on it.
I don't know.
Look ahead. See these runes? They indicate the way to Sylveon. We should arrive shortly. After a long trip, it was a relief to finally see the Kamloops runes. I could barely keep up with the boy as he dashed through the woods. I knew what was on his mind. The safety of his people. And of his dearest friend, Luxana.
Sylveon, city in the trees.
At long last, Sylveon, the majestic capital of the Kamloops. That was quite a journey, wasn't it? I was almost starting to like you.
The capital
is protected by a barrier of nets and traps. To reach it, we will need to undergo the 5 trials.
Great.
Your people have this unpleasant habit of making everything so complicated.
That's where the... That's where the whole box thing comes in handy.
This is your ritual chamber. Please tell me you remember how to solve your own tricks?
Not a clue.
Luxana's? Don't make that face. I bet she's safe and sound inside the capital.
Now what? Eventful encounter with Slesh in the Viperius Forest, it was time to hear the Council's verdict. The Night Elves brought us in the Council's room. The Elders were perched high above and appeared on us from above. It was as I had feared, their decision sealed the fate of our mission. They didn't care about our problems and ordered us to leave Number at once. I had failed. I had failed my crew, the Six Nations, and our civilizations. Tried to make them understand the gravity of our situation. tried to convince them to give us a chance, but they didn't want to hear any of it. The more I talked, the deeper I dug my grave. Why should we welcome you lot in our ancestral land? I've seen so little of you. It has been enough to convince us that your kind cannot be trusted, one of the elders said. Enough. We've wasted too much time too much of our precious time with these humans. Let's drop them into the chasms of the unknown depths and be done with it. Another one chimed in. They all started to laugh. The unknown depths? Who are those? According to the Night Owls, any fool that dared to explore the unknown depths was never heard from again. It was a cursed place, avoided by all at the northern tip of Nova. Many legends circulated about the place, and no one truly knew what was going on down there. That gave me an idea, a last gamble I was willing to take. The Night Owls didn't want us here because we'd not proven our worth. And to be fair, their reaction was totally understandable. I, Paddlewood, would go to the unknown depths and uncover its mysteries for the Night Owls. They promised to welcome the Six Nations here. The elders exchanged looks and gathered together on the highest branch. After some deliberation, they agreed to my proposal. As you wish, foolish Paddlewood. In any case, we will be rid of your kind pretty soon. Seemed a new adventure awaited us. effects. Minute here. Got it.
This one looks like a riddle. Not your forte, I presume.
This ambulation is not a curse, but a blessing. Lost and disoriented. Remember, it's unorthodox travels. There is no definite path to reach your goal. Embodying the ferocious heat of the sun, its bravery and might command authority over the darkness. It alone shall reign supreme. Embodying the heat of the sun, bravery and might command authority over the darkness. I think it's the cat. Misperceived and misunderstood, one must read its heart to realize its true intention. A loyal guidance through the lonely night. That's a bat. That's correct. Know what that is. Oracle of knowledge and foresight, wisdom intertwines dreams and reality. Listen to its counsel to undo the shadow. Well, that's gotta be the owl. And is sensitive to its surroundings, its true sight can unravel lies, ambiguity, and illusions. Unexpected ally devoted to your cause. Let's try the bat again. Okay. That's the cat. Okay, that's two pieces grabbed. Preparations for a final journey to the unknown depths. We've traveled across Nomad. We've seen its many dangers, but also its many beauties. It was only fitting to be the ones to uncover the mystery of the unknown depths. The crew was anxious to be about this ordeal, but relieved at the same time that our mission would not come to an abrupt end. With Shen and his warriors at our side, we were in good hands for whatever we might face down there. Gripix came to my room as I was packing the last of my belongings. He had a stern look on his face. Paddlewood, I know the Council's answer wasn't what you and your people were hoping for. Please go back home. You'll find nothing but death in the unknown depths. This is coming from a friend. I knew Gripix meant well, after everything he had been through. I also considered him as a friend. Alas, I preferred to face death than come back empty-handed to the Six Nations. We'd come so far, we had to push forward one last time. I knew the crew shared the same sentiment, and I told them as much. I promised Strypix that I would convince you to abandon this folly, but it looks like you have made up your mind. I wish you good fortune, then. He sighed as he handed me a map of the forest and the secret passages. I joined the rest of the crew at the Order's main entrance. I said farewell to a sobbing Strypix. and gave him the rest of my arrows before he went down the elevator. He flew away, fighting back tears. He wandered north for the rest of the day, carefully following Rippix's path, examining the dark sky, wondering if the darkness of Numbra was somehow linked to the unknown depths. Maybe the origin of the darkness could be found there. When I first set foot in Numbra, I wanted to uncover this mystery, and in the end, I'd completely forgotten about it. Alright, last one.
See the light in her actions, and said that the Kamloops fate was now taken care of. And since we refused to surrender to Eternium, she would have no choice but to deal with us herself. Luxana, I instinctively lunged forward and wrapped my wings around the boy. I refused to let another pupil down. A fitting end for the last night owl. It was the other celestial gods who saved us from being reduced to cinders, but in my case, the damage was already done. Up against four divinities, Luxana was forced to retreat. She claimed that she had delayed us long enough and vanished. Incapacitated by her powerful attack, Firas, Shin, and Orlog were in no condition to keep going. From their investigation, only one place could host Eternium's base. It was up to Nox, and him alone, to free the Tamroots and face Luxana. And to do it, he would have to venture into the unknown depths, a place whence none ever returned.
Dun dun dun.